series so far, so I figured why not just share with you one of my most beloved handbags, and it is none other than the Prada Velvet Constellation Cahier Bag. So this bag is called the Cahier Bag. I'm not too sure why, because in French translating into English, that literally means notebook, but I think that probably means that the design is kind of like, I don't know, let's be honest, I really don't know why it's called that, but it is a cute bag overall, and I generally love it. I have the black velvet with the constellation studs all over the front. You can typically find this bag without the constellation patterns anywhere, and just a simple buckle. It's a pretty standard design in Prada right now, and they have a bunch of different varieties of these in different colors, finishes, and textures, so it's a pretty popular standard style when it comes to Prada. I'm gonna give you guys a little bit of a backstory on this bag before we jump straight into the analytics and my pros and cons as to like why I like the bag, so let's start there. I've had this bag for about, I think, 2 years now. I bought this bag when I went on my first ever trip to London to visit my friend Camilla about 2 years ago. I already knew instantly that I wanted this bag in particular. I had originally wanted it in leather, but I believe that one, by the time I went to London to get it, was completely sold out. It was an old design. So I figured, you know what, there's a velvet one. I don't have a velvet bag, and I love the texture of it. So let's try to track it down and see if I can find it. This bag is extremely, well, not extremely rare, but it's extremely hard to track down because they didn't make too many of it, and it was an exclusive limited edition design. I've seen a couple of the leather editions floating around available online and in stores, so if you do really want to get a hold of this one, you can probably try to track it down. But the velvet version is definitely no longer being sold, at least to my knowledge, and it's really hard to track down and find existing designs of this bag to also repurchase on consignment. So when I went into London, this was the very, very first thing that I purchased, I believe, on like the second day there. We were there for an entire week, and I knew I really wanted this bag. I left Canada on my flight going to London without a single purse on me. I only literally traveled with my ratty travel backpack because I knew that as soon as I purchased this one, I would be using it the entire trip, and I was not wrong, guys. I literally used it almost every single day. If you search back to all of my London content that I shot on my Instagram, you probably will see this bag popping up everywhere. And that's to say I'm not sick of it now and I don't wear it anymore. I still definitely do wear it, but I definitely don't wear it as much as I used to 2 years ago when I first bought it. So after tracking down this bag, I didn't even hesitate. I instantly told the sales associate, like, pack it up, let's go. I found my bag, I'm happy. And that's essentially what happened. There's no like crazy story when it comes to this bag, other than the fact that we had to go to a couple of different Prada locations in order to be able to find this one. I ended up purchasing this bag at the Bond Street location, so if you're trying to look for bags, try that one as well too. I don't know if it's any different from the other ones, but that's where I got this one from, and I figured that if you guys are curious, now you know. So let's dive right into the analytics of the bag, my thoughts on it, the pros and cons, and whether or not this should also be a purchase that you're contemplating as well. So let's first talk about texture of the bag. This bag obviously is velvet, and there are definitely a lot of pros and cons when it comes to velvet. Obviously, the number one is compared to leather, you're not gonna scratch it unless you guys happen to take like a knife or scissors at it and really hack at the bag, then you'll see a lot of texture. But I can legit, I don't know if this is easy for me to show you guys, but I can legit run my nails up and down the back of the bag, no scratches, and I'm not afraid. The worst that'll happen is you may just get some like textural streaks that go along with it, but if you just literally rub it out with your fingers, it's gone. It looks like it's brand new all over again. So that's one aspect that I truly love, because as you know by now, I don't take the best care of my bags, and they do sometimes get dinged up. So when it comes to material for me, I like to have an easy, fussless type of material on my bag so that I can ensure that it's always gonna look great. So there is a con when it comes to velvet, and that is that it attracts a lot of dust. I have a little dog, you guys have seen him already, his name is Kobe, he's a white little Pomeranian, and he sheds like no tomorrow. When he sheds, I find a lot of dust ends up sticking to this bag, and also just regular dust in general. I'm not sure if you guys can see, I'm hoping that this picks it up close up, but there's little white pieces of dust all over the front of the bag. It's not to say that it's difficult to clean, all you have to really do is take like a lint roller, roll over it, or get a piece of tape, put it on your fingers, and just kind of like stick it on until you remove all the dust. It's just annoying because then you do frequently have to clean it to ensure that it looks its best. Other than that, I have zero problems with velvet. I think it's a great purchase. And as long as you do some research to find out which brands have the best velvet, you're gonna get the best bang for your buck. I've heard that Gucci velvet sometimes balds in spots when it rubs up against your body or like your hips when you're using it too much. So far, when it comes to my Prada one, it is absolutely pristine. I wore this like literally nonstop the year that I bought it 2 years ago, and I have not seen a single bald spot on any of the leather so far. Has not faded, still looks fantastic. So moving on to this little buckle strap in the front here that interlocks to keep the bag shut. This is done in the signature Prada Saffiano leather. So this is a very much treated and texturized leather. It also doesn't pick up a lot of scratches if you're gonna go back and forth with your nail. It's very sturdy, very rugged, and super scratch resistant, which I absolutely like. If you're the type of shedding your bag. You can definitely see a lot of scratches occurring to the front of this where it constantly rubs up against the buckle. So I love that it's super resistant to everyday wear and tear. And that's essentially it. It's very sturdy. I haven't gotten any scratches on it. And both sides are the signature Prada Saffia leather. Moving into the interior of the bag, we're also going to be talking about the leather in here as well. The lining actually is all leather. I don't know exactly what type of leather it is, but it very much feels like lambskin. So that means super fragile, super soft, and very easy to nick and scratch. Luckily for myself, I haven't quite scratched anything yet. Like, I'm looking inside of it right now and I don't really notice anything. There are no scratches up along here from when I like dig my hands in, nor on the back. And then on the inside, if I'm looking immediately, there's not much going on there either. So on my end, I've been able to keep the leather fairly clean thus far and smooth, knock on wood, because I don't want to damage it. But other than that, the leather inside is very soft, smooth, supple. You do just have to be careful if you're throwing keys into the bag that you're not scratching it up in the inside. All right, so now that we've done discussing about the construction and the leather of the bag, let's kind of talk about the overall design and like the hardware aspect. So we're moving on to aspect number two now, which is hardware. As you can see, there is a butt-ton of hardware on this bag. Obviously, right at the front, you have the Constellation kind of like press onto here. I'm not sure how they're applied. When you open it, you don't see them on the other side, nor do you feel them. So I feel like they might be like glued on or heated on or, I don't know, somehow pierced through and they have been attached on the inside and you can't feel it. I've been wearing this bag for 2 years now and my biggest fear at first was, what happens if any of the Constellation pieces fall off? Can I get it replaced from Prada? Never really had to ask that question thus far yet, just because none of them have fallen off. They're all on there pretty tight, and if I like try to jiggle around any of them, I really don't feel any of them coming loose, so I have no fear of that whatsoever at all. All the hardware in the bag is the exact same. It's kind of like a really burnished brush gold, and it's definitely a yellow gold. It is very yellow. I'm not the type of person who loves yellow gold hardware. I typically gravitate towards silver. This was the first bag that I purchased that had yellow gold on it, and it kind of converted me over into a yellow gold girl. As you may have noticed, in the Celine bag, it's also a yellow gold, but it's like that brushed kind of finish, so I'm okay with that. If this was a shiny gold, probably not as much. So moving on to the front clasp here where the buckle goes in, there's like a little front clasp that opens up here. It's also yellow gold, and then the inside, there's this piece where the bag kind of like locks onto. A couple things I did want to note is that the gold on here kind of rubs off after a while, so it's going to be really, really hard for me to show you guys, but the two corners here have slowly kind of deteriorated and it's now kind of silvery. I'm not sure if that's something that Prada will be able to offer and to help you fix, but just want to note that the edges will kind of rub off slowly over time. I guess it's just been plated with gold and it's not actually solid gold all the way through, otherwise this bag would be like astronomically expensive. Besides that aspect, the front clasp here has gold on the outside and also gold on the inside, and this really helps to protect the leather up against the clasp up front here, so you're not scratching and getting a lot of like nicks on the leather. That does make the bag fairly heavy though. And then on the bottom in the front, you have the whole portion down here in the front flap, and then on the back you also have the similar rimming underneath on the bottom as well. Because this bag is velvet, there are no feet on it. I did want to mention that having these two on here really helps to keep the bag supported and kind of protect it when you're putting it down on surfaces. But also because it is velvet, I don't tend to put it down on dirty surfaces that I may deem could potentially get the bag dirty easily. So I did compare this bag mainly because of the material, but I did want to note that it is pretty strong and sturdy in the way it's designed, and it's going to withstand being put down on surfaces pretty well. So now let's chat about the logo a little bit. It's right up at the front here. It says Prada Milano, typical. When you open it inside, you also have a little Prada logo kind of emblazoned onto here as well. And then there is a chain that comes with this bag. I just keep it stored in here when I'm not using the bag so that it saves space in my cabinets and that it's not rubbing up against the leather of my other bags that I own. So this bag comes kind of like half chain, half strap, I guess. There's a drop chain from here to there and on either side, and on the top is a Saffiano leather shoulder strap just so that it sits easier on your shoulder. It is a thin strap, but it doesn't cut in, so it's fairly comfortable. I can truly envision that if the entire strap was made by this chain only, it would be very painful on your shoulders purely because the bag on its own without anything in it is quite heavy already, and if you were to put more stuff into it, it would just get even heavier, and that's not fun. You don't want to have like your straps cutting into your shoulders, especially if you're buying a bag that's this expensive. You want to be able to use it comfortably day in, day out. So they were smart and they put the shoulder strap on top here. The length of the chain is not adjustable. I find that it's a little bit too long to wear just on my shoulder. That's a stand up right now. Hopefully you guys can see. This comes down to like past my hips and I don't love that look. I typically like to crossbody this bag a little bit and it sits comfortable. This is exactly how I like to wear this bag. Now, you can hold a bag in different ways as well. You open the inside of it. The strap is actually attached via like two buttons in here. They interlace over and they snap shut, so you can take off the strap and turn it into just a clutch if you'd like to and just hold it as an evening bag. Very easy to remove. Another way I really like to wear the bag, loop the straps around. So this is the bag here. I'm gonna take this side, put it around underneath, and then do the same thing for the other side as well. Then the only problem with this though is that it's a little bit tricky to kind of shut the bag because it gets pretty tight. So you just gotta be careful of how much you're stuffing the bag so that you're not damaging the structure of it. But after you seal it, you just have a simple top handle like this. And it's pretty cute as like a little clutch that you can wear on the side. Just wanna wear it just like this. Otherwise, I wear it crossbody at all times. Don't think the bag was meant to be designed to be worn like this necessarily, but I like it and I think it's cute, so I do it. Now, if I take the strap off, I guess the strap in its own is kind of like aspect number three because there's so much about it that I love. So we're gonna move on now to aspect number four, which is the storage and the size of the bag internally. I can fit quite a bit of stuff into here, but it's definitely not as big as my Celine Fox bag. I can easily put my iPhone 8 Plus into here, my wallet, also my keys, and like one of the lip products. This definitely is not like a bag that you're gonna bring out and put everything into. I more or less use this as like my going out bag, or if I know I don't need to carry much during the day, then I bring this one. If I know I'm gonna deal a lot throughout the day, this is not my go-to bag. But it's great and it carries just the right amount of stuff that I need for like a minimal day out. Moving on to aspect number five, we're gonna talk about the color of the bag. I know that when this bag first came out, it came in a variety of different colors for the velvet. I decided to go for the black because it was truly classic. Velvet is already a little bit out there in terms of texture when it comes to handbags. I like to have a lot of my handbags be leather just because I know that over time they kind of like age really well. So it's a nice classic. Velvet, not so much. Comes and goes. It's a very trendy material when it comes to a bag. So I want to keep it as classic as possible by purchasing it in a black. I have no problems with this. It's crazy that because it's so emblazoned and embellished on the front that a lot of people think that it's hard to pair with many different outfits. But for some reason, this bag actually goes along with everything that I wear. Like, it's crazy. I more or less treat this bag as like a visual accessory as well besides just a bag. Like my Gucci Soho Disco bag, it's very plain and simple. It's not something that you focus on when you're looking at an outfit. It's definitely not a statement piece. This one 100% is. So when I wear this bag, I know I don't need to worry about having like makeup, perfect hair, perfect like jewelry accessories on because the bag does all the talking on its own. And it's one of the few bags that I use as a statement bag because you guys know I tend to like my bags to be fairly simple and blendable in with my outfits. I don't know what the right word for that is. That sounded really stupid. I don't know. Other than that, I don't think I have much else to say about this bag. I truly love it. I think it is a great piece and a nice, beautiful addition of a statement piece to add to your closet if you're sick and tired of your regular, everyday, black, basic bags. If you're not at the point where you're financially kind of like comfortable spending money on statement bags, I wouldn't necessarily gravitate towards this one in particular with the constellations on it. You can definitely get this style in the regular boutique. You can definitely get the regular style in the boutique still and kind of get away with a similar look. You'll just be missing the constellations. I've also seen quite a few other brands add a lot of embellishments onto the front of their bags as well. If you're looking for that kind of embellishment look, but you're not able to secure one from Prada, I know YSL does quite a few of them. I know Gucci really enjoys all their patches on their bags. So if you're looking for that look, try those two brands. Otherwise, if you do want the overall design and aesthetic of the Cahier bag, Prada definitely has so many of them still in the stores, and I think they come out with new colorways every single season. I hope you guys really enjoyed that review of the bag. It's one of my favorite ones. I think I say this every single time I do a review besides the Chanel Gabrielle backpack. All the other ones I truly love so far, seems like all my black ones I like. Note to you guys, if you like black, you'll probably like all these bags as well. I think I need to really like play around with my options and explore outside of my current collection when it comes to colors. I have my eye on the Dior Saddlebag, the monogram logo, I think it's called the Diorama in the burgundy color, which I'm hoping to pick up on my upcoming trip to Amsterdam. You guys will see in the vlogs when I vlog my Amsterdam trip as to whether or not I'm successful to picking it up. But yeah, I honestly couldn't say more good things about this bag. I don't think there really is anything that I dislike about it besides the aspect of having to constantly maintain and clean the velvet just because it attracts so much goddamn dust. But I think this is a great purchase on my end. I tend to purchase my bags when I'm on a trip somewhere more as like a souvenir piece so that I have kind of like an emotion and a memory attached to the bag as opposed to just an impulsive purchase in souvenir stuff. So that's my justification, and like,